Hello everyone, we hope that you must have gone through our part 1 of research aptitude questions, and today we begin with part 2 of the research aptitude sections for UGC NET exam paper 1. So let us have a look on the topics that we'll be covering today. So the topics for today are ethics in research, our research process and research design. So today we'll be dealing with the questions from these two topics. These three topics are very important. Let us have a look at the first question. Which of the following are not one of the ethical norms in research? Read the questions carefully. Which of the following is not one of the ethical norms in research? Let us have a look at the options. First, patent policy. So patent is all about protecting your technique or a new product or a new idea. So this is one of the ethical norms. So this could not be the answer. Next, data sharing policy. Data sharing policy is regarding your respondents' data or the answers that have given to you in the questionnaire in the research process. So again, this is one of the ethical norms to be followed. So this is not the answer. Third, copyright. Similar to patents, copyright is the protection of your literary works and your books and the other works you have done in the written form. So copyright is again not the answer. Trademark. So trademark is a distinctive symbol that distinguishes a product from the other product. So trademark is not the ethical norm that we have to follow. So in this case, trademark is the answer. Let us have a look at the second question. The act of devising a structure that outlines how the research shall be conducted is known as. Focus on few words. The act of devising a structure is to be devised, that would be outlining how the research shall be conducted. So this, if you point out to these key terms, this clearly tells you that the term they are talking about is research design. So have a look. Research philosophy is definitely not the answer, because we know that research philosophies are the philosophies in research, such as positivism, interpretivism, as well as realism. Research policy is again not the answer, because it is a guideline. Research methodology is regarding the methods you will be following in conducting your research. So definitely the answer to this question is research design. Let us have a look at the third question. Which of the following best describes the meaning of ethics in research? So we have to find out the option which best describes the meaning of ethics. Quality of research. Quality of research is about how well have you conducted the research. Next, fulfillment of research values. So here they are talking about the values. This could be an answer. Let's have a look at other options. Impact of research. This is again after effect of a research, that what is the impact it has led to. Again, this is not the answer. And all of them, again, this is also not the answer. So the answer to this question is, which of the following best describes the meaning of ethics is B, fulfillment of research values, because values are the elements that decide what is wrong and what is right. So this is the correct meaning of ethics. Let us have a look at the fourth question. Degree of control is a feature of which method of research design? So remember that we had studied four research design, and any one of the research design uses the element of degree of control. First, observational method. So in this method, definitely we just have to observe. There is no element of degree of control. Experimental, in this we use several variables to test the previous principles. So this could be an answer, because you'll have to control certain variables. Test, this is simply a test that you have to conduct, whatever test you use, whether it's a statistical test or it's a research tool test, anything. Survey, again, it's a simple method where you have to ask questions from the respondents. So test and survey could not be the answer. So the only suitable answer in this case is experimental, since you have to control some of the variables. Let's have a look at the next question. Research is not considered ethical in which of the following cases mentioned below? So below are certain cases mentioned, and we have to identify that which of the following is not considered ethical. First, findings are subjective. So the word subjective means that everyone will have their own individual opinion. So here this could be an answer. High standards of accuracy are ensured. So this is definitely a very good element, that high standards of accuracies are ensured. Next, anonymity of sample units is maintained. So anonymity means you are not disclosing any of the details regarding the respondents. So this is again a good ethical norm. Next, data is scientifically investigated. So you are using scientific methods of research. This is again a good norm. So this could not be an answer. So the only element or the only case which is not considered ethical is findings are subjective, because findings should be such which could be generalized at the global level or at the national level so that it could be meaningful. If the findings are subjective, differing from individual to individual, then these findings could not be utilized for research purposes in future. So this could be the best answer. Let's have a look at the next question. While writing a research thesis is the detailed orientation of how you will be conducting your research. A researcher shall not consider which of the following elements. So again, one of the elements is not to be considered. Language medium, choosing the medium of language, whether you'll be using English, Hindi or any other language. This is one of the elements, so this could not be an answer. Number of pages. So the number of pages used for writing the thesis could be an element because we need not consider the number of pages, whatever limited goes. Structure of thesis. This again has to be taken into consideration, how you are going to structure your thesis, the elements, the content part, the literature review part and everything. So this is again an important element, so this will be considered. Next, typing errors. You definitely have to consider typing errors. There is no scope for errors in a research thesis. So this is again an element. This could not be an answer. The only answer to this question is which of the elements are not to be considered in the research thesis is the number of pages. Let's have a look at the next question. Review of literature is an act undertaken by researcher for. Recall students that the review of literature is regarding the past findings that has already been conducted in the research. So guys, we have to focus that review of literature will be related to past findings. Now let us have a look at the options. Going through a thesis again, this is not the option. Examining previous findings, this could be an option. Let's have a look at the other options. Giving proper references, this is referencing, this is not the answer. Asking another person to review your work, this is again not the answer. So the only answer to the suitable to this question is examining previous findings. So the review of literature is related to examining previous findings. Let us move ahead. Listing the books, journals, etc. consulted for a research work is known as. So the all those books, websites, journals and the things that you are referring are known as. Referencing. We have already discussed that referencing is regarding the styles that you use while quoting references. Footnotes are the elements that you place at the bottom of the page of your thesis. Bibliography. So this is the term where this comes at the last page of the thesis, where you classify all the elements, book, whether it be books, journals or websites that you have actually referred for conducting your research. So the listing of books, journals, etc. consulted for research work is known as bibliography. So bibliography is a suitable answer. Let's have a look at the next question. Which of the following is not a part of data analysis? So we have to find an element which is not a part of data analysis. Let us have a look at the option. Classification of raw data. This is a part of data analysis because we have to classify the data. Tabulation, making tables based on some homogeneous characteristic. This is again one of the part of data analysis. So this is not the answer. Generalization. Generalization is generalizing our data so that it can be used at the universal level. So this is not the part of data analysis. Rather, it is a part of research in the last stage. Coding, again coding of data. This is again part of data analysis. So this will not be answer. So the suitable answer in this case is generalization. Let's have a look at the next question. A good research can only be produced in case of. So there will be elements of good research and we have to identify them. Good library. So you definitely need good library, but to a certain extent, because more than library, you'll have to use your own mind in using those books in the library and other materials. A genius, a person though might be genius, but if he doesn't has his analytical mind or if he doesn't uses his mind properly, it will not be considered to be a good research. Next, a penetrating and analytical mind. So this is one of the characteristic of conducting a good research, because if you have penetrating mind, if you are curious to learn about new things, develop about new analogies, then only you can talk about good research. So this is the suitable answer for this question. We hope that these questions must have cleared the elements of ethics, research process as well as research design. Till then, keep watching our videos. Thank you.